2K Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
I'm Kevin Harlan, joined by Chris Webber, Greg Anthony on our sideline, is reporter David Aldridge. And a bit of a treat for all our fans out there. The one and only Kobe Bryant's going to join us for this portion of the broadcast. Kobe, what a great honor to have you with us. Thanks for stopping by.
No, happy to stop by. Thanks for having me.
You might have a career in broadcasting, though.
I'm good.
No chance, huh?
No, thank you.
I'm glad we've got you tonight. Western Conference battles, always fun. This time it's the Los Angeles Lakers intent on protecting home court. And we've got time for a quick pregame report. With that being said, let's head to the sideline and our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge. D.A.?
Hello, Kevin. Well, Blazers head coach Terry Stotts is one of the more respected offensive minds in the game. He said, "I like to give our players freedom to read the defense and make plays. I like, philosophically, that I don't know who's going to get the shot. That's going to cause a problem for the defense. Keep them guessing, Kevin."
And as always, thanks, D.A., that kind of unpredictability helps in some settings, can cause many matchup problems for the D. Some say, Kobe, that the shooting guard crop in the NBA right now, a little light in terms of depth, not quite as many top two guards as we used to play the game. Who do you like among some of the two guards you see now in the NBA?
Well, it depends who we're considering a two guard.
Right, now, because you know,
the ones, twos, threes, they all just blend.
Combo guards, yeah. You're playing some forward, because it's tough, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah. Right, so, you know, shooting guards to me are guards that have to do everything. You have to be able to play the post. You have to be able to play the perimeter. You have to be able to play the point. You have to do everything. So I put Russell Westbrook in that category. I put James Harden in that category. I put Kawhi Leonard in that category. There's a lot of players I'm forgetting. Even Giannis, I would say, is two guard because of what he does.
Yes.
So there's a lot of talented guards out there.
Did you like the ball in your hand, bringing it up, or would you have rather someone else bring it up, then get it to you in the half court, and then do what you did?
Yeah, that's the one thing I'm jealous about Michael. Because Michael didn't have to do that.
Yeah, Pippen. Yes, right. Who always brought it up.
Yeah, so he could focus on coming off the screens and catching and shooting. He didn't have to think about facilitating first. He could think about scoring and then passing out of double teams.
Let's take a look at our starters for Portland. The incredible pair of Lillard and McCollum are at the 1 and 2. Nurkic is out there with Mo Harkless. And it's Turner in at the 3 slot. Ingram kicks to Randle over Harkless. That's good from Randle on the assist from Ingram. Randle's got his first points of the game. And Kobe, you talked about coming off screen. Some guys come off a screen and kind of just lollygag. You came off and you pass the ball and then get back at it
efficient.
Again.
Efficient.
Explode off those
the angles, right?
Yes.
You got to be able to read those things. And when you're catching, you're in attack mode all the time. But then it's demoralizing to the defense.
I'm sure it is.
You're always on.
Yeah.
You're always looking. You're always checking. You're always in fear that he's going to attack. So we always try to keep our foot in the gas.
Always.
Or foot in the throat.
Yeah. And it's Ingram missing.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get many looks better from that range.
And the trend around the league, Kobe, is more offense, more three-pointers, certainly spacing, fluid offense. Scoring is up around the league in a measurable way from, it seems like, year to year. Do you like the way this is trending, or do you think the NBA should maybe put a governor on this, harness it in just a little bit?
Well, I don't think it'll swing back to the way. I mean,
do you?
Yeah, because the game has gone through that progression before. You know, it's constantly evolving. And so I think you'll see it swing back eventually. You'll have a couple teams that are just big and may have a dominant post player, and all of a sudden you're going inside, and then that team will win a championship, and then the rest of the teams in the league will try to copycat the way the game is played that way, and then things will swing back. So it's just natural evolution of the game, I think.
The first free throw is good.
Well, think about the high ceiling that this kid Brandon Ingram has. I mean, and with his long arms, I mean, he could reach the rafters.
And so he hits both. And Kobe, how did you learn to watch tape? Because there are guys now watching tape and they'll just go, and you wonder if it's really even sinking in.
Trial and error.
Yeah, right. But really, that was it.
Trial and error. You know, you start looking at things, you start saying, man, like if I'm watching an edit on a player and I watch one particular game, and then I look at the next game, and he's doing the same thing. And the next night, he's doing the same thing. Hold on, let me go back and watch. And then you start looking for consistent behaviors or patterns in their behavior. And then you think, okay, maybe that's something that's a tendency for him. Let me go back and check. Two dribbles, turn. Two dribbles, turn. Two dribbles, turn. Two dribbles, turn. Two dribbles.
God, yeah, there it is. Here's the pattern.
Right, so what if I interrupt him between his first and second dribble and throw him off a rhythm? What'll happen then? Right? What if I know he's going to go 1-2, turn right shoulder? I let him go 1-2. Now I jump to his right shoulder. Now he can't turn there. What happens then? Right? You throw him off of their pattern.
Larry Nance has checked in for the Lakers. Turner dishes to Lillard. Nurkic setting the pick for Lillard. Here's Harkless. Good. Great play by Lillard to set it up. And Kobe, you played for a handful of coaches during your career. When you look back on it, was there one coach you wished you could have played for but didn't have maybe a chance to play for?
Greg Popovich. That's an easy one for me. Although I did play for him in several All-Star games.
Yes, you did.
And one particular All-Star game in practice, he came up to me and said, okay, do you want me to just kind of go through like a whatever practice, or do you want me to do a real thing? I said, Pop, you got to do a real thing, because I've been dying to see what really goes on inside these Spurs practices.
Oh,
you gotta,
my gosh.
You got to give us a real practice, man. Yeah. And he did. And Tim just kind of looked at me and was like, dude, seriously,
what are you doing?
Come on, you're killing me.
So what was a Popovich practice like for you, and how did you try to set the tone?
It was high energy. And we moved from drill to drill. And it involved a lot of passing and moving and spacing. And so all of the shooting, it wasn't any individual shooting. You know, all the individual shooting took place within a five-man offensive structure, mm-hmm. a ball movement, a passing and cutting. And all of a sudden, your shot comes here in the corner, and then you slide up to the next line. And, you know, you dribble, penetrate, and kick it, and then you slide to the next line, dribble, penetrate, kick. Right? So it involved constant movement where you're constantly training and conditioning the body that you're not just going to pass and stand and be a participant. Right? You're going to be involved into in the action. You're not going to be a passive participant.
And Kobe, your spectacular high school career at Lower Merion High School in Philadelphia, and that Philadelphia area, paved the way for your NBA career. Talk about some of the highlights of your days in high school.
Well, my days in high school were fun. I mean, I played in a small high school called Lower Merion High School, so not too many people heard of it. You know, when you come to Philadelphia, the schools that you hear of are Overbrook, where Wilt Chamberlain went to school, Bartram, right, where Earl the Pearl Monroe went to school, right? But you don't even ever heard of little old Lower Merion High School, right? So it was a huge honor to be able to bring a state championship to Lower Merion. It kind of put Lower Merion on the map, and that's the most exciting part about it.
Oh, a terrific story indeed. A huge honor, I'm sure.
And really just a great play to sacrifice his body and take the charge.
Here's what the Lakers are going with right now. Zubac is checked in for Lopez. Bang comes in for Ingram. And it's Jordan Clarkson in for Ball. Portland also making some changes. Ed Davis is checked in for Nurkic. Collins comes in for Maurice Harkless. And it's Aminu in for Turner. Now here's Dang. Pass to Zubac. Six on the shot clock. He kicks it to Clarkson. And he can't extend the lead to double digits. And Kobe, you've had so many fans from high school that carried over to your NBA days. In the stands now, in fact, you'll see fans with Lower Merion High School jerseys on.
How cool is that?
That's amazing.
How cool is that? You know, to actually be able to see a bunch of Aces jerseys in the crowd when literally nobody knew where Lower Merion was. There's actually a school called Upper Merion. So everybody used to confuse the two. You say, hey, yeah, I saw you when you played at Upper Merion. I say, hold on, dude. No. Lower Merion, man. Get it right. Don't forget it. Lower Merion.
Here's Zubac. Buries it down low. Zubac has got his first basket of the night.
Defensively, they've got to pick up the intensity. Hard to win surrendering this high a field goal percentage.
Aminu, the pass to McCollum. There's a good screen. Three-pointer, Lillard. With the putback, he hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
Love the determination he showed there, getting himself into good position under the glass.
With the presence of mind to know just where the rebound was going to come down. Well timed. Now here's Caldwell Pope, and again it's the Lakers from deep.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
Lillard outside. Davis inside, and the rejection by Zubats. And so it's the Los Angeles Lakers. Their lead at 11 points to end the quarter. And thanks to their outstanding defense, the impact Damian Lillard has had on this game has been minimal. We'll get right back to the action when we return. And now a chance to hear from point guard Damian Lillard. He explains his stoic demeanor on the floor.
I was taught to, you know, never let anybody see how you feel. I kind of just embraced it, you know, for my entire life. Just, you know, you wouldn't know if something was going on in my life or not, because as long as I'm taking care of business and doing what I need to be doing, you know, that's all that matters.
I would say we probably shouldn't expect to see Lillard starring in any reality shows about his personal life.
Lillard is a young man who is all about taking care of business.
Welcome back, folks. We'll see if we're in store for a more tightly contested quarter as we move here into the second. And guys, the Lakers are pretty much in control here.
Just playing suffocating defense. That's been the difference here for them.
And really, for the whole first quarter, they've maintained their intensity. Let's see how long they can sustain it.
And a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. On the floor for Portland, they've got Collins. He's out there with Al-Farouq Aminu. Damian Lillard out there with Davis. And it's Connaughton in at the shooting guard position. Now here's Lillard. The Trailblazers need to get off a shot. Fades. Misses off the right iron.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
Here's Randle. Hits the target from 18 feet. And the Lakers lead by 11. And you look at the NBA today and the social media, Kobe, a lot easier for NBA players to connect with fans over that social media platform. However, it's also easier to get people in trouble. Players have got to keep that periscope up, so to say. How hard do you think that is to manage?
Well, you know, I think now in this particular generation, the sensitivity towards things you may hear or see on social media is much different than it would have been years ago. In other words, nowadays, for athletes to be on social media, it's more easily tolerable for them to say something, right? Or to be able to speak their mind.
Yes.
And I think the important thing is just the consistency in that. You know, if you have a thought and you want to say it, right? Put it out on social media. Do whatever it is that you want to do with it. The key is just to be consistent and be who you are and not be afraid to be who you are.
And Jordan Clarkson is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul. Ball's checked in for the Lakers. Portland also making some changes. Swanigan, he's checked in for Davis. Noah Vonleh comes in for Collins. And Turner's subbed in for Lillard. So timeout called here, the first for Portland. So I think for players, Kobe, when they've been criticized on social media, I think they feel it's better to sleep on a reply and see if that same thought still resonates the next morning, because a lot of in the heat of a post game, you read something, guys go off.
Yeah, they do. And you're at the same time when that does happen, because it's going to happen. No matter how many times we say it, it's going to happen.
Yeah.
And when it does happen, to be able to step back and say, okay, yeah, that's how I felt in the moment, and I said what I felt.
Yeah.
And here's why I felt that way. And now you're ready to move on. I mean, it's a lot like life. I mean, people say stuff all the time that they don't necessarily mean, right?
I never felt, though, that you ever said anything that you truly did not believe in your heart.
Yeah, well, I think most people do, right? When you're having a moment, you're looking at it, you say, you know what, should I send this out on social media? Yeah, I really, really believe this. I really, really do. And then you send it, and the next morning you're like, now, what did I do?
What? You had no regrets.
No, I mean, everything's a life lesson.
For all of us.
Yeah.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agenda.
And there's the whistle. Illegal screen. Well, Kobe, it seems like the NBA is becoming less a position-based and more of a skill, positionless game. Perimeter skill now seems to be at a premium. Do you agree with that? Do you like that? Would you change that?
Well, I think players need to be able to play all positions on the floor, right? If you look at the teams that win championships, they generally have every player that's on the floor can make a decision.
Mm-hmm.
Every player can dribble, every player can pass, every player can shoot, right? There's a reason why San Antonio's always finding themselves there in the end. The reason why the Cavs are finding themselves there in the end. It's the reason why Golden State's fine. Because they have playmakers at every position on the floor.
They have basketball players.
They have basketball players, right? Not specialists. They have basketball players.
And another three for the Lakers.
And the D has gotten a little bit laxed here defending the triple.
Kobe, there are a lot of great guards and wings in the league right now. When you look around, are there any that remind you of the way you played or maybe are approaching, you know, going down that road and say, I want to be like Kobe Bryant. Yeah. I watch a lot of his tapes, much like you did when you were growing up.
Yeah, well, Isaiah has a hunger and a thirst for the game.
Mm-hmm.
And he's not going to stop. He's constantly curious. He's constantly
his
working.
His size makes him a different kind of guy, though.
Isn't that unbelievable, though?
It is shocking.
That's unbelievable. But he can finish at the rim. He can shoot the long ball. He can pull up left and right. You know, he has great physicality and a great body about him where he can punish bigs at the rim. And the other is Kawhi. I mean, when I watch Kawhi play, I'm just looking in the mirror. You know, the moves, the positions on the floor.
I'm so glad you said that. I feel the same way.
Yeah, it's unbelievable, and it's a great, great feeling because, you know, I'm sure Michael felt the same way. Right? When he retired and you watch me play, you're seeing the same spots. You're seeing a person who studied, the person that came before, and there's no need to reinvent the wheel when the wheel's already been created. You just put it on a different car.
Well, you know, he has been guided by his coaching staff to watch you and Michael Jordan tape. And
yeah.
I think that's kind of what he's done.
Yeah, well, we've connected. We've talked about this stuff before in the past. And, you know, again, he's a curious kid.
And all business.
Yeah, curious. He steps out on the floor, he's all business. There's nothing funny. There's nothing silly going on. He's here to do his job. And he's here to help San Antonio win games.
Here's Harkless following the basket by Brook Lopez, trying to get back on track. Rebounded by the Lakers. Randall's got three rebounds so far in the game. And we'd like to thank you for stopping by, Kobe. Hope you come back and join us again.
I definitely will. I had a great time, man. Thank you for having me.
You know, Greg, it's amazing to think back on Kobe's career, but to hear the perspective and context in a broadcast setting like this, it's an awful lot of fun, isn't it?
It really is. And you know, the depth of knowledge from the kind of career Kobe has had, the ups and downs, and the wisdom gained through that experience really shows in him as a person, not just a basketball player. He's one of the truly special people who've given so much to the game of basketball.
Again, the miss by Turner.
It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Here's Clarkson. Portland grabs the miss. Connaughton's got his third rebound tonight. Harkless kicks to Turner. Turner can't get that one to fall.
Whether he's wide open or cover, he can't get anything to go in right now.
Here's Ball. And it's he nails the buzzer beater.
Great awareness of the clock to end the quarter.
I like that. Even though he's in a hurry, he still remains under control.
And so it's the Los Angeles Lakers with a 19-point advantage heading into the next quarter. The scoring has been tremendous, and they are shooting lights out with very high accuracy. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Kentavious, you've been able to produce easily and efficiently in the first half. What's enabled you to keep it going?
I'm just moving on the offensive end and just finding an open spot. They turn their heads a lot, so I'm just trying to get to the open spot and then knock down a shot. Either I'm cutting to the basket or spot up for the three.
You've been on a roll so far. We'll see if you can keep it up. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks so much, Dave, for the great interview. Don't go away, folks. We'll be back for the second half of basketball right after this.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, y'all. Welcome back. Ernie Johnson here with Kenny the Jet Smith. That's Shaquille O'Neal. Thanks for joining us. And boy, a pumped-up home crowd is behind us right now. What a start it was for Brandon Ingram. He had 8 points, 5 rebounds, and 1 assist. And let's get your thoughts, Kenny, on the Lakers.
Well, it comes down to confidence. From the opening tip, these guys had that swag. They had the attitude that you can't beat us. We could only beat ourselves.
Shaq, how do you think Portland played?
They were brick city, and it was painful to watch. Weak shooting starts to get contagious, and they were struggling all over the place. They got to work on getting more high-quality chances, more layups, fewer prayers.
And time now to send you back down to the floor with Kevin Harlan. We'll see you later.
Well, we're getting back to the action now. It's been a one-team show so far. We'll see if that changes here in the third. Brandon Ingram with a strong contribution so far in this one.
Yeah, so far they haven't found an answer for him, a scoring machine here in that first half.
Oh, well, he's a tricky cover. He does a good job of sensing the defense, making the right move at the right time.
And as we welcome you back, we begin our second half. So far, not a tightly contested game, guys, but, you know, anything can happen. Trailblazers trail by 19. And, Chris, it's a players' league. And yet the officials, of course, have an impact on games. I'm thinking of a certain Game 6 back in 2002. In your opinion, how does the league ensure greater consistency with the officiating of games?
Well, I promised myself, Kevin, thanks for bringing up 2002, that I would never think about that aloud. You know, I'm going to have to go lay on somebody's couch after we do this game right here. But I think the league just has to be transparent. They have to let fans know when the ref has messed up. We're all human. So I think it comes into play when you aren't transparent, when you aren't honest with your fans, because we have the smartest fans of any sport, I believe. And so I think transparency is good, but human error is always going to be in there as long as it doesn't go back to the type of human error we saw in 2002.
But, Chris, I do sense that is a goal of theirs, and bit by bit they're getting toward that goal.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, you know, I believe that our league has done some great jobs when it comes to advancing referees and how the game is officiated. When you look at not only do we have the referee center back in New York, where the referees now can go and get help and the game is faster, and also, you know, we have three refs on the floor, and so and we have the best conditioned refs, and so I think the game is just going to be better because we have passionate refs, we have passionate officials and passionate players, and we're going to work together to make sure that this game is the best for every fan to be presented to, and also that every player has a chance to win a championship and don't have their heart broken.
The young pair of Ingram and Randall are at the forwards. Ball runs point with Kentavious Caldwell-Pope to his side. They're the backcourt, and it's Lopez in at the five. And that's the group for Luke Walton as we begin the second half. And it's Ingram missing.
He gets the shot he was looking for, and he just can't bury it.
All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. Hey, the Portland Trailblazers are developing a great chemistry for our young team. Damian Lillard takes the team to San Diego every September for bonding purposes, and he told me how much we like each other, how much time we spend around each other, that shows you a team that is really together. It is a unit. We have each other's back. Kevin?
And it's critical to establish camaraderie early on. Thank you, D.A. Sounds like Lillard has this team headed in the right direction.
That type of defense doesn't always get it done, but it does the job that time.
And Lillard kicks to McCollum. Over Caldwell Pope, and C.J. McCollum again.
Oh, they lean on him for a big portion of their scoring, with a good reason.
Lakers leading by 13.
Yeah, and C.J. McCollum mostly plays at that off-guard spot with the Blazers, but on a lot of teams, you could see him as the lead guard. I mean, 6'3 in height, and his handles are elite.
Now here's Randall. Nice ball movement here by the Lakers. Lopez, a screen on Lillard. Ball dishes to Lopez. Second chance shot, and Ball with the lay-in. Ball's got 7.
There's just a feel that Ball plays with that really separates him from so many other players. He's superb at finding ways here to score in the paint.
Now a timeout called by Portland. And C.J. McCollum can step into that point guard role very comfortably.
Yeah, I mean, he keeps it on a string going right or left. A terrific ball handler. Calling him a secondary ball handler is almost not doing him justice.
Lakers with some changes. Zubats is checked in for Lopez. Nance comes in for Julius Randle. And it's Dang in for Brandon Ingram. And then for the Trailblazers, Ed Davis is checked in for Harkless. And it's Aminu in for Evan Turner. Now, here's Lillard.
Aminu.
Feeds to McCollum. From deep three-point range, Trailblazers keep it alive. Out of hand on it.
And that's the battle they haven't been winning today. Their work on the glass has been porous, and that's got to change.
Stolen by McCollum. Not quite 2.5 minutes played here in the second half. Kicks it to Lillard. He dishes it to Aminu. Passes it to Nurkic. Over Nance. Here's Davis. And the rebound paying off as they pick up two on the second chance bucket right there.
Now look at that. That's just a great all-around play. Getting into position for the offensive rebound. Finishing strong on the putback.
And it goes down 2 points. Tang's got his first 2 points of the night.
Well, Terry Stotts now in his sixth season as head coach in Portland. I mean, he'd been a head coach for a handful of seasons elsewhere, but this is by far his longest run with a single team.
Screen by Nurkic. Here's Lillard. Nance with the rebound.
Well executed. Great rhythm. You've got to finish that one.
Yeah, coming off of a good pick, you want to get that one. He gets the separation he needs. I know he would love to have that one back.
And by all accounts, Terry Stotts doing a great job with the Blazers.
But this team has chemistry and a defined style of play. The new players love him. I mean, Stotts himself seems really happy and important. It's been a great match.
Nice work there coming off the screen. Aminu's got 5 now.
Well, Lillard's so solid at moving the ball. When one of his guys has a clean look, he quickly gets it to him.
Caldwell Pope kicks to Nance. To the wing on the left. Caldwell Pope against McCollum. Just 4 to shoot. Nance a screen on Davis. From the wing. Another miss by Dang. Trailblazers trail by 12. 1:46 left in the third quarter of the game. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot 2 here. Lonzo Ball picks one up. And when you look at Damian Lillard, Rookie of the Year back in 2013, tremendous confidence from day one.
A quiet assassin who carries himself with humility. He lets his game do the talking.
And for Damian Lillard, Chris, last season arguably his best yet as far as individual numbers are concerned. And yet again, he was snubbed for an All-Star game.
Well, he just calls it wood on fire. I mean, Lillard, a 2-time All-Star, he probably should have made it a few more times. I know he feels that way, but he's not focused on the accolades. He's focused on winning.
And he knocks down the first one. And the Blazers with 3 first-round picks under their control this last summer. That's where you want to be.
Definitely. Picks 15, 20, and 26 in a strong draft class. That could really help reinforce a roster.
Jordan Clarkson, he's checked in for Ball. Portland also making some changes. Collins comes in for Yusuf Nurkic. And Vonleh subbed in for Al-Farouq Aminu. And both free throws good for Damian Lillard.
Well, he's not making any mistakes up there today. Another solid trip to the line for him.
Dang kicks to Clarkson. Zubac's the pass to Clarkson. Shoots over Lillard. And again, no good by the Lakers. The Trailblazers on offense. They're on a 13-4 run. Here's Vonleh. The putback and a miss there with a chance to cut the lead to single digits. Here's Dang. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Tang's got 4 points this quarter.
Yeah, liking the vision there from Caldwell Pope, looking to get his guys going when they're open.
And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot 2. And where have the shots been coming from tonight? Here's a look, broken down by paint, mid-range, and 3-point shot attempt so far for Portland.
And the corner three has not been their shot of choice here tonight. And I think a big reason for that has been the defensive setup. They came in focused on taking away the short-range triple.
Shooting 2.
And that one falls for Collins. And the Lakers, Greg, for a long time could rely on the lure of Los Angeles to draw top free agents. History does a lot, it seems.
Yeah, Paul George listing them on his short list shows they still have that pull, but the Lakers will be big players in free agency, I believe, in the near future.
Maurice Harkless is checked in for Portland, and he makes both free throws.
And they came out of the locker room after halftime with a much more physical approach than what we saw in that first half.
Aldwell Pope dishes to Clarkson. Nance a screen, and the call is going to be, yes, it is, an illegal screen.
Yeah, still moving a little bit when he set that screen. He'll argue that he was set, but I really didn't think so.
I think you'll probably see more arguments on those illegal screen calls than just about any other play, maybe the charge call, but guys never think they were moving.
Los Angeles making a switch here. Ingram's checked in, and the Trailblazers making a change here as well. Turner's checked in. Now here's Turner. They set the pick. The feed to Harkless. Conley's hitting the pick for Harkless. Goes up from the top of the key. Again, the miss by the Trailblazers. Los Angeles leading by 10. And no one near Clarkson as he lets it go. Great look, but off the mark. Now Harkless. Turner with it. McCollum outside. Over Caldwell Pope. Portland again missing.
And low percentage look on that one. Not sure what he was thinking.
Well, sometimes you get a little outside of yourself. You have to be a little more disciplined.
And so it's the Los Angeles Lakers with a 10-point lead. Some breathing room heading into the break. They've been playing some ferocious defense. We come back right after this. And let's listen to head coach Terry Stotts review the game plan with his guys.
Right now we're playing 10. We're backing down. We're throwing soft passes and you're getting us in the hole. Be aggressive.
Typically a measured guy in this approach, Terry Stotts trying to turn up the heat on his guys.
And that's because he knows when his team is attacking, that's when they're able to go on those runs.
Welcome back. Fourth quarter action starting up. 2K Sports, happy to have you with us. And on the floor for Portland here in the fourth. McCollum at the two with Harkless playing the three. Swanigan is out there with Collins. And it's Turner in at the point.
And how about the 46th pick back in the 14 draft? Jordan Clarkson has certainly exceeded expectations thus far in his career. An athletic combo guard. He's really succeeded playing at both the one and two.
And, Greg, Jordan Clarkson, he has an offensive game, doesn't he?
He's able to shoot with range, and he can attack off the bounce as well. I think that enables him to kind of play on or off the ball. And I think he has a chance to be a really good two-way player in our league.
Two shots. Relax on the first.
That free throw, no good. And for the Blazers, tremendous scoring talent in their backcourt. How did they turn the corner in the West, Greg?
Clearly, it's going to be with their defense. I think that's where they've had their struggles. They're going to have to get better at the point of attack there and protecting the rim. I think some of it has to do with the lack of discipline, but also you could factor that into being just an inexperienced young group that's still kind of getting their feet wet.
And the second free throw, good.
Former first-team all-rookie after being picked in the second round. Clarkson, a draft day steal.
Clarkson against Turner. McCollum with a screen on Caldwell Pope. Here's Swanigan. He's defended by Randall. The three from McCollum. And Lopez pulls it down. Lakers leading by 11. Here's Clarkson. Sinks the three-pointer. Clarkson's got 4 points in the quarter.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
And Turner kicks to Collins. McCollum outside. Here's the screen. He can't hit that time. Caldwell Pope with some nice D.
He's not the only one to blame for them being behind, but he hasn't helped their cause much.
Lopez a screen. Launches it. Rebound by the Trailblazers. Next matchup, they'll be home against the Suns. That game marks the first half of a quick two-game homestand. Now here's Turner. Back to McCollum. There's the dish to Turner. Portland, no good that time either.
Boy, he has been cold for a while now.
And it's sad because the team relies on him to be a threat offensively. When he's rolling, that makes them a much more dynamic offense.
Trailblazers trail by 14. Dishes it to Collins. Pass to Swanigan. They set the pick. And a wide open look for McCollum drills the three-pointer. Chris, there are so many players that can make you just scratch your head and contemplate, how did they make that play? With that in mind, which players just amaze you the most with what they can do on the floor?
It's so many. I mean, look up there and let's look at the Splash family. With Kevin Durant, the fact that he can score with ease off the dribble or on the catch. And look at Thompson, his partner, can get you 60 points off of 11 dribbles. So just catch and shooting. And Curry, he's Mr. Video Game. He is the human video game. He shoots, makes, and takes shots that you would think no one else has the right to take. So those guys already. But then you have younger guys like Antetokounmpo up there in Milwaukee, his length, his athletic ability, his love for the game, his passion. Watching him get involved in those games, he's so exciting to watch. He comes to mind as well.
And that one's good. Ingram.
Ingram operated well off the screen. Very agile for his size.
Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over.
Julius Randle is a great fit as the role man in the pick and roll. First off, he sets some bone rattling screens. And when he catches the ball in space, he's a threat to drive and pass.
Now we've got a moment for our Jordan player of the game, Brandon Ingram.
And the way he's made his mark with his work inside, he's just been a slasher tonight. Always moving, getting to the basket at will, and just seemingly taking advantage of a D that was reluctant to get in his way.
And the Lakers making a change here. Ball's checked in. Portland also making some changes. Nurkic checked in for Collins. And Lillard subbed in for Swanigan. Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Hi, Kevin. Well, Terry Stotts just went over his game plan with his team. He said, guys, I know you've worked hard. I know you're a little tired, but we got to dig deep right now and find a way. Take a deep breath and let's get it done. Kevin, we'll see how they respond.
And Randle improving his scoring efficiency last season.
Look, you give him space to attack, he'll capitalize. Great quickness for his size, the strength to finish through contact.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And free throw good from Lillard. And the Lakers have picked second in the draft now for three consecutive years. Out of all the players they've acquired, Chris, who do you think has the chance to be the best, Ingram or Ball?
Well, I definitely like Ingram. I think his upside, his potential, his athletic ability. He's wiry. They played him a little at point last year. His rookie season wasn't dominant, but that doesn't mean anything. I really like his game. But I really like Lonzo Ball. I think he brings that talent and leadership. I think he has the talent to become that franchise player. And forget what I think. Magic thinks that.
Ball. And Ball slams it in.
And Ball is certainly capable of throwing it down thanks to his size. I mean, easily lifting off the ground and just finishing that one with authority.
Now here's McCollum. Screen by Nurkic. The shot by Lillard wide open. That falls. Nice feed that time from McCollum.
Oh, simple screen, but there was a defensive mix-up that left the man wide open.
Guy, it's a good chance for them to slow it down.
Yeah, they definitely should use some clock here.
Caldwell Pope kicks the ball. Over in the corner, Randall. Caldwell Pope outside. And another three for the Lakers.
And Caldwell Pope can be a volume three-point shooter, meaning when he gets a lot of attempts from there, he can fill it up from downtown.
McCollum with the ball. Now guarded by Caldwell Pope. Screened by Nurkic. Lillard against Lopez. Lillard, the pass to Harkless. Basket, good.
Look at the unselfish attitude. Lillard is fantastic at hitting his guys in their spots.
Lakers leading by 12. Ball dishes to Lopez. He feeds it to Ball. 1:16 left in the fourth quarter. Here's Caldwell Pope. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. It's going to be on Yusuf Nurkic.
Well, you really like seeing Caldwell Pope earn these calls on a shot. I mean, it makes him that much more difficult to guard.
At the line for two.
That free throw, no good.
Well, I just watched KCP out there, and whether it's on the ball or off the ball, he's so active with his feet and his hands. He's so hard to shake. He can hound a perimeter threat all game long.
And he's good on the second. And with KCP, he'll often draw the premier perimeter threat as his defensive assignment, which he welcomes. More often than not, Chris, he'll find a way to slow him down.
It's his ability on both ends on the floor. KCP, his skill set, that's what coaches love about him. He can lock you up on D, but he can also be a challenge for a defender on the other end.
No question as to which team gave the better effort tonight. A dominant performance and an outstanding win for Los Angeles.
And the big difference here was accuracy from three-point range.
And once they started sinking shots, it really stretched out the D and created other opportunities. And anytime they got space, they seemed to just knock down another triple.
And it'll go down as their first official win of the new year.
They can chalk this one up, but these two teams will see plenty more of one another before the season's over.
And a lot of players tonight help contribute to this performance, but in particular, a real good game it was for Brandon Ingram.
He was too much for them to deal with tonight, plain and simple. They tried all sorts of ways to contain him, and nothing worked.
One shot.
There's 37 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Ball kicks to Clarkson. Lakers working the ball around now. Ball with the bucket.
And giving the fans what they came to see, a spirited performance.
Yeah, with a double-digit lead at this point, they can pretty much mark this one up in the win column.
Here's Connaughton. Davis sets a screen. There's 14 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Count that one.
And that tells the tale here today, guys. Throughout this game, they've been able to get the ball in tight and finish.
There's 10 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. And here is Ball. And so it's the Lakers taking care of business here. A confident win and one where they clearly showed the greater effort.
Yeah, I mean, it was a solid performance, particularly here at home. And I think they built off that edge of being here and playing with just a little more confidence than their opponent.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. Luol, huge win tonight. How did you get this done?
You know, we locked in. We locked in. We knew how good they were. And we know when we're at our best, we could beat anybody. When we lock in like that, we're hard to beat, too.
Well, you led the way, Luol. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. And that'll do it, folks. For Chris Weber, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.